Hey folks, good afternoon everybody. My name is Kian Saemian and I'm the Senior Business Development Manager at Mackevision. And our topic for today is the utilization of virtual reality solutions specifically for the automotive industry. And today I would like to give you some very nice insights about what is happening inside the automotive industry and how Mackevision actually is empowering big OEMs in order to achieve their highly ambitious tasks. Before we start, I would like to give you a very brief company presentation and tell you what Mackevision is actually doing and where we are coming from. And for this, I've brought with me a very nice showreel, which is probably self-explaining. So we start with that right away. Enjoy.
I'm early like the sunrise.
Showreel actually is showing our last productions, what we're doing. And as you can see, obviously, we are focusing the automotive industry. And for me personally, it's still amazing to see how far we have come with the CGI technology. So even for professional people nowadays, it's actually impossible to distinguish between what is real and what is CGI. And I think this is a very nice summary of how far you can get. So, maybe just quickly, Mackevision at a glance. Mackevision was founded in 1994 in Stuttgart-Sindelfingen, so more than 20 years ago. And we have right now 13 locations around the globe, which enables us to provide our services, products, and solutions to the automotive industry. And it's no surprise that we have offices in Detroit, in Hamburg, in Stuttgart, the headquarters, in Munich, and in Seoul, as an example, just to name a few of them. And with our staff number of 450 people, we are able actually to provide highly complex projects in parallel. So it means we want to deliver for many OEMs at the same time, and therefore I think it's mandatory to have this kind of manpower. And with our portfolio, which is actually divided into services, products, so self-developed products and solutions, we are, with this profile, right now the biggest independently owned CGI company worldwide. And this is something we are very proud of, definitely. And at the same time, this is, I would say, a big differentiator between us and our competitors. Because we at Mackevision, before we start creating innovative solutions, we are going to take our long-term expertise, combine it with our creativity, with our services and products, and of course, finally, to take cutting-edge technology in order to come up with innovative and unique customer experiences. And this I would like to prove in the next 20 minutes. So, before we start with the examples showing virtual reality, I would like to emphasize the topic customer journey. And customer journey nowadays is probably a very popular buzzword. So everybody actually is using it. But what does it actually mean? So we at Mackevision, we have a clear understanding of what a customer journey actually is. And as you can see, an example, if a customer wants to buy a car, so from this decision until the final delivery of the car, we have so many steps in between. And normally we are talking about something like 6 or 7 months. So this is the process. So during this time, the customer has a lot of touch points. And we are talking here about entry points. And in general, you have 3 major entry points. So in other words, we have the home scenario, which means you are sitting in front of your PC, you are in front of your laptop, or you're using a smart TV actually to get in touch with your product to get more information. The second one is the store scenario, which means flagship stores, retailer stores, showrooms, and even exhibitions. So probably this one is very important. And the last one is the mobile entry point. So it means everything which is in between. And so we have 3 major categories. And during the customer journey, it's really important to know that it's highly possible that a customer gets disappointed at a specific entry point. In other words, before an OEM starts to put everything into one entry point, which is probably the POS version or the store version, and at the same time neglecting the home and the mobile scenario, this is definitely what we want to avoid. We at Mackevision, we are up to create a comprehensive, streamlined solution where you have the best possible and suitable application from the start to the beginning, right? So this is really important. And as you can see at the bottom line, so many opportunities, so many use cases where you can create unique experiences. And this is really important to know. And on the left side, we have virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. And the question is how to combine them. So it's not just like you take virtual reality and you project it to every use case. This doesn't make sense. So you really have to know when to use which kind of technology. And on the left side, you see I intentionally left out the classical CGI productions. So we are talking about animations, TVCs like you have seen in our showreel, or classical renderings for print campaigns, catalogs, brochures. So this is still today a major part in the customer journey. But I would like to keep the focus on new technology, and as an example, virtual reality, and how Mackevision is incorporating virtual reality solutions to come up with a unique approach. So let's focus on the entry point as a store. So we are talking about the next generation and the best practice of point of sales and point of experience solutions exclusively for Mercedes-Benz. And I would like to start with a little teaser. This is a cutdown, actually, of our last production, what we are doing right now for Mercedes-Benz, and then to show another video which explains all the functionality and the possibilities you have with this solution. So can we fire up the teaser? Hopefully. This one. So this is again a cut down of the latest production, what we're doing right now for Mercedes-Benz. And this is fully real-time application. So all the cinematics you've seen, this is no rendering involved. And we are very proud of our real-time department and of the guys, what they're doing right now. So some of them are sitting directly here, so you're doing crazy stuff, definitely. So please fire up the next video in order to show some of the features of the application. So the basic idea is to set up a new kind of product experience, and especially by incorporating virtual reality. So every thing you see here is real time. We are using right now the Unreal 4 engine for our applications, which is, from my point of view, one of the most powerful engines right now which you can use. So basically, this is a car configurator. And right now you see the screen version, so it runs on 2K or in 4K. But just for demonstrating the visual quality, we are showing this as a screen version, and later on you see the VR support. And basically, the cool thing here is the customer is not just a spectator anymore, where he's looking at a screen way off in the distance. He's right now the director, so he's changing actually the position, and he has the control how to interact with the product, what kind of angles he wants to see, which kind of features he wants to see. And this is the power of virtual reality, especially as a point of sales or a point of experience solution. And here you see some basic features, fully dynamic, and also the light is dynamic. So as you can see, the seat, when the door is opening, the light situation will change, and also the shadows. So this is not a static baked situation, actually. So now the user is in the center of gravity. This is a basic idea what we have here with the point of sale system. And you will later on see the virtual reality glasses. So you can really implement, if you like, the HTC Vive or the Oculus Rift in order to create an immersive feeling for the customer and to create a complete new experience, I would say. So this is definitely different, because now you can interact with the product and normally you would just play animations or you see just images. Finally, VR support, and as I said, you can move around, you can open the doors, go inside, start your configuration, interact with all the features, and this is actually just a foundation which can be added easily with much more extensions. And if the customer is finally ready, so he made his dream car actually, he can get a real-time cinematics of his final car, and this is again happening in real time, so there is no rendering involved. And of course you can use smart devices, so if you like to use an iPad or a tablet to control the application, so either it is the dealer actually or the end customer, and easily can show some nice features of the car which would normally be very complicated to demonstrate. This is it. I hope you liked it. So this is right now what we're doing for Mercedes-Benz, and the plan is actually to extend the system. And basically, just to make a summary out of this, now the customer can use this kind of solutions for the store touchpoint, which can be the retailer store or flagship store, for exhibitions, as I said, or for showrooms. And this is one picture of the Mercedes-Benz Me store in Hamburg, where Mercedes is actually planning to have a rollout in such kind of stores. So it's a different environment. It's more like a cafe where you go in and drink an espresso, read a newspaper, and then you have the opportunity to use virtual reality actually and to have a different kind of product experience. And this is where we're up to. And it's exciting to see where we will get in the next 2 or 3 years when also the technology will evolve. So very exciting stuff. I've also brought another topic with me, and basically, everybody right now is talking about point-of-sale solutions, so we are talking about external solutions for the final customer. But the thing is, what the heck is going on inside the facilities of the big OEMs? So talking about design and engineering. And I hear very often the question from people from the outside of the industry, and it goes something like this: Kian, is it true that the guys at the BMW in the design or engineering departments are doing crazy NASA shit? This is a question, actually. And I'm like, yes, they do. They definitely do. So unfortunately, I have to disappoint you. And Mackevision is proud to be part of this most exciting project right now, I would say. And it's called the BMW Mixed Reality Lab. This one is an enterprise solution. So actually, this is happening behind closed doors, and you will not see actually what is going on and how Mackevision is empowering BMW by incorporating real-time solutions in order to improve their internal process. And this is really a nice one, which shows again the power of the latest technology and how you can come up with a new approach in order to increase the efficiency, to increase the productivity, but at the same time lowering the cost. This is the idea of the BMW Mixed Reality Lab. And in a nutshell, it's about the next generation and the future vehicle development. And as you can imagine, the process of creating a new prototype, the process of creating a new car, is mind-blowing, actually. We are talking about several years of design work, of engineering work, of manufacturers, and so on and so on. But to cut the long story short, at specific stages in a process, BMW has to build physical mock-ups. So this is what you see in the middle of the picture. And this is just the cockpit, without the roof, without the front, and without the back. And the crazy thing is, this physical mock-up costs something like 1 million euro, right? 1 million euro for just one mock-up. So this is just one configuration, which is the usage is actually for design approvals or doing design decisions or presentations, and also for the engineers. And you can imagine, they need to build a lot of them, right? So this is actually really crazy how the process is working right now. And if we make the bridge again to the customer journey, where we say we always look at the big picture, we listen to the customer, and then we start to create a concept or a solution in order to solve the problems. We at Mackevision started the solution in order to come up with a new approach and to improve the whole overall process. And this is actually what the Mixed Reality Lab is. Unfortunately, due to confidential reasons, I can't show you images right out of the application. But I think this gives you a basic idea of what we're doing right now. And Mackevision is setting up the environment of the virtual environment and setting up the virtual cars, actually, for the virtual reality solution. And I would like to give you a picture of what it's all about. Imagine you're a designer or you're an engineer, and you and your colleagues are putting on the HTC Vive as an example. Then another colleague is sitting in the back office. He's actually the operator, so just like in the film The Matrix, right? He's steering the whole application. And now he can load up different kind of environments, outdoor, indoor, exteriors. He can change the weather conditions. He can change from nighttime to daytime. He can load up quickly and instantly in real time different model states, different prototypes, right? So it's unlimited opportunities they have actually with this kind of setup. And now the engineers and the designers can walk around the car, actually, and do the design approvals in a virtual space. This is actually what it's all about. It means they can interact with each other. They can communicate with each other. They can interact with the product. And it's like they're going around, talking about the design lines of the shoulders, they're making their modifications, talking about the front lights, and so on and so forth. And everything in a virtual space. And for me, this is most impressive to see how far we are right now with virtual reality, and especially for the enterprise solution, and how to improve, actually, the efficiency and reducing the costs. Because our idea was, basically, to reduce the amount of physical mock-ups and to save money, right? So it means maybe, probably, to reduce the amount of 10%, and at the same time, using the virtual solution for all the design approvals, for all the engineering approvals, and so on and so on. So this one is really a nice example and shows the power of virtual reality. I would like to give you another picture to the end of this application, which is still an outlook, but this is where we want to go with BMW. So imagine you are a lucky guy, right? You're located in Los Angeles, you're working as a designer, in the lab of BMW. you and your colleague are putting on again the HTC Vive, and then you get warped in into the virtual space to do your design approvals or your collaboration work. But now another guy enters the room. Unfortunately, he's not so lucky. He's located in Munich and is working as a designer in the research lab. However, all of them are now in a virtual space doing their collaboration work, although in the physical world, they are separated, right? So two of them are located in Los Angeles and one is sitting in Munich, but this doesn't matter. With this system, they can do their collaboration work, their approvals in a virtual space. So there are no boundaries actually anymore. There are no limits anymore. And this is where Mackevision is trying to help BMW to go to the next level, right? And especially to go and to create the future and the next generation of vehicle development. This is where we're up to. So quickly make a summary. So I've shown you an external example, so best practice for Mercedes-Benz. And this, what you see here, is just an excerpt of use cases or fields of applications where you can use virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. So we have seen a very nice example of a point of sales and a point of experience solution. And I've also showed you an internal enterprise solution for designers and engineers. And I can tell you, this is right now just the beginning. So we are really at the state of opening the door. And if you just take 2, 3, or 4 more years, it is most exciting to see how far we get, and especially how Mackevision can help the big OEMs to improve their internal processes. And for us, it's most exciting because we at Mackevision, we always try to push the limits, to go beyond the borders, and especially to be pioneers also in the virtual space. So that's it actually from my side. I hope I could give you some insights about what is happening in the automotive industry and how Mackevision is empowering big OEMs to achieve the highly ambitious task. Thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the exhibition. Thank you.
We have time for 2 or 3 more questions. If anyone wants to ask something directly. Could you wait for a second? We have a microphone. Come on.
Yes. So this is Werner Strathaus from Technicon Design. You were talking about this collaborative mode for your design development VR scenarios for,
yes,
for your automotive customers. The automotive customers are very keen on project security. How do you protect against product piracy while doing the collaborative mode between Europe and USA, for example?
Yes, so this is definitely an issue, what we are discussing also with BMW. But actually, this is something which is happening inside at BMW with the IT department. So this is nothing where we normally have access to. So this is something that they are handling and trying to solve. What I can tell you is they are right now setting up a system in order to avoid that they get hacked or that there are some leaks actually in this kind of system. But for BMW and for us, this is actually not a game stopper. So there are ways how you can solve it, right? Depending on how the system is set up, especially if it's an internal cloud solution, which could be the foundation actually to have a virtual space or a centralized virtual space for different locations like Los Angeles, Europe, and the Asian market, where all can come together. But this is definitely a hot topic, but I'm quite confident that BMW's IT department will solve it.
So you put that problem to your customers in a way?
Yes, this is something, unfortunately, we don't have the option to handle all the problems, right? This is just another example is, if you are doing the data preparation for BMW, this is something, it has to happen inside the facility. So this is what we are doing at Mackevision, and it's not allowed to send out the data, and we are talking about the source data. And in this special case, this is something the IT department will handle, and there is no way actually that Mackevision can go into this topic.
Is there any cooperation between Oculus or HTC Vive? Because if you look into their terms and of their project, you can see that they actually allowed to take pictures or capture pictures if you're working online with the HTC Steam environment or even with the Oculus. Mm. That's actually, you're right, it's a hot topic in the industry, how to protect against product piracy. Yes. Which obviously doesn't apply to filmmaking or to if you're working for PR purposes, but if you're working in product development, this is a really hot topic. So, how do you deal with that? I mean, if you say you work with Oculus, do you plug the cable and work offline, or just to protect the system from taking pictures of where you are?
So we started actually the project at the beginning with the Oculus Rift, but as you can see, we're talking about moving around the product in a virtual space. So it's it was right at hand to use the HTC Vive, and this is right now the setup for the BMW Mixed Reality Lab. All these kind of topics, and I'm quite sure I can't actually give you more insights, but this is something where BMW is cooperating with HTC, so they are very tight. And I'm quite sure that they will find a possible solution to this. I can't imagine that BMW is opening up such kind of a door where they get leaked, actually, and something is getting out. This is also the reason why I can't show you actually images. So this is highly confidential, but the idea actually is nothing new, right? The interesting thing is that they are doing it right now with the state of technology you have right now. And but this is something definitely internally at BMW.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
No more questions? Then thank you very much, Kian.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye.